For more great videos and learning tutorials, or to download the exercises that go with these videos, please visit our website at www.createthenet.com. That was www.createthenet.com. Hi, and welcome back to our series of videos on web design. In this video, I'm going to start showing you how to use divs and CSS to lay out a website. We're going to go ahead and look through several different formats, but in this video, we're going to go ahead and look at this format. You can see this is basically a one-column, very simple layout. We've got a header up here at the top. We have a menu bar up here at the top, a main content section, as well as a footer down here at the bottom. Now let's go ahead and look at the code behind this website. You can see here I have my page open, and I can look at both the source code right now, and using this new feature in Dreamweaver, I can see any related files. So I could also look at the CSS file just as easily. So you're going to see here, I'm going to scroll up to the top, we've got a normal head section, and then we open the body tag. Now there's going to be an opening div here called wrapper. And that actually is going to contain all of the other divs inside of our layout. Some people call these constraining divs, because what you can do is you can set the properties of that div, like the width, the margin, the padding, and all of that will automatically be applied to your other divs that are inside of that. So if you make the wrapper div, let's say 800 pixels, and you make all of the other divs inside of that wrapper div the width equal to 100%, as you change the wrapper, the design will expand or contract. So it's always good to contain or to create like a wrapper div. And then we have a very simple header div that has our site name on it. We have a navigation div right here with four links inside of it. You remember that's up there towards the top. Our content div with just a few paragraphs of information, and then our footer. And then again, we close that wrapper div right down there. Now, when we look at the CSS for this is also fairly simple. I set a body tag right here. But then as far as our div tag styles go, we've got a style for the wrapper, for the heading, or for the header, the navigation, the content, and finally the footer. And then again, I placed a few class styles down here. Tag styles down here again. And then I also created the CSS that was necessary to make this rollover effect right here. So some very simple styles and some very simple HTML code will get you to a basic clean layout like the one we've just been looking at, this one here. And again, this was all laid out with CSS and divs. None of it was laid out using tables. So let's go ahead now and create the documents and get started creating this layout. So here you see I've gone ahead and created just a plain old HTML file, and I've linked it to a sheet called one.css. And you can see the style sheet right here. And we're going to begin by going ahead and building again this HTML document. Now, as I mentioned before, we're going to contain all of these divs inside of a wrapper. So I'm going to go ahead and do div ID equals quote. Now, if you define your CSS styles for your divs before you actually start creating the HTML file, you'll be able to select from your styles, your div styles, from right here. But in this case, I'm just going to go ahead and type in the name. So there's my first div. And again, this div is going to contain all the divs, so I'm coming down here below my body tag and closing that off. Now, there were four main divs inside of our design. And they were for the header section, where the page header is. And I'll close that one. And again, you can see, I'll indent this in to make it a little more visual, how that's embedded in the wrapper div there. And then we had the navigation area. And I'm going to go ahead and call that nav for short. And then we actually have the content area. And finally, if I close that div off, we have the footer. Oops, forgot my quotation marks. That's a common mistake people make when they're doing the IDs, is they forget their question marks. They also forget to close their div. So make sure if you're having problems with your design, make sure all your IDs are in quotation marks and all your divs are actually closed. And then I'll delete those extra spaces. And there we have it. There's that outer div wrapper. And here are the four items inside of that div wrapper. Now, since these are completely empty, if we actually go into live view here, you're not actually going to see anything over here. They're just completely empty containers. You can't even see things, even though we have some of our visual aids on in design view. Turn off live view here. You'll see I'm just going to see that one outer dividing line, not all four divs. But once I've added content to this, that's when we'll be able to see the divs. So I'm going to go back into code section here, and I'm going to begin in my header area. I'm just going to tab myself in, and as a main heading, I'm going to go ahead and type welcome to my website. I will close that off, and that's all I actually placed in my header. So there we have that. Now we have our navigation. And you remember on our navigation, we just had those four choices for home, product, services, and contact. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to open an unordered list. If you haven't watched our videos on creating unordered lists for navigation, go ahead and look at our CSS navigation videos. And I'm going to go ahead and type in home, close that off. We'll create our next menu item, products, oops, and this might be something that you actually do in design view inside of Dreamweaver, because it's very easy outside of live view just to simply click, type, and do contact. I'll go ahead and tab that in there. And there we have that. So I have my wrapper ID. I have my div statement inside of that. I have this navigation div right here. And I have my two other divs here. Oh, you know one thing I forgot? I forgot to do the closing UL tag. There you go, just like that. Now you'll see that. And I'm going to go and indent that over. One disadvantage of going into design view is that if you have spaced out your items, if you've spaced out your items and indented everything in nicely, it won't continue to maintain that. I'll go ahead and place an H2 inside of the content area, along with just a sample paragraph of text. And then finally, I'm going to go ahead and inside of the footer, I'm just going to go ahead and type this is the footer area. Oops. Close my P tag. Click over here. You'll see those other two divs have come to light now. My header div, my navigation div, my content div, and finally my footer div. Remember, these are all constrained inside of a wrapper. In our next video, we're going to begin to look at CSS and how to format these different divs into a workable layout. And you can see now, if I go ahead and I'm going to right click up here and do save all, And then I'm going to click here and let's go ahead and preview this. That's all we've got right now. So there's no formatting at all. Also, if you're interested in seeing the high definition 1280 by 720 videos, please go to createthenet.com. When we upload these videos to video sharing services, they always shrink the video size down and decrease the quality, so they come out a little bit fuzzy. If you go to the website, you can see the full resolution versions of these videos.